Yes, dear children, we'll have a small recap of the friendly mongoose. Then we'll go into the question time, right? A farmer, his wife and their small child lived in a village. This is what I read, isn't it? The next two lines I didn't read, right? There was also a baby mongoose in the house who they believed would be their son's companion and friend in future. Now, who is the friend? Mongoose is the friend. Whose friend? The small child's friend, right? One day, the farmer and his wife went on, leaving the child alone with the mongoose. What will happen after that? Once a farmer and his wife lived in a village with their small family, small son. Okay, they loved that son, small baby, very much. And one day the farmer said, we should have a pet. Wife also accepted. Wife thought that this is a great idea. Why the farmer said we should have a pet? Because he thought that when the pet grows, this will be a great companion for the small son. Right? That's why he decided to have a pet. She too thought, the farmer's wife also thought this as a good idea. One evening, the farmer brought him a tiny mongoose, small baby mongoose. When we are saying about pet, we will think about dogs, cats and other pet animals. But here, he is bringing a small baby mongoose. So, it's a baby mongoose. Why are you bringing all these here? Who said this? Wife said. But it will be very big soon. It will grow very soon. He will be the friend of our son. Do you think your parents will accept? But this farmer accepted it and wife also accepted it. Baby and mongoose grew together, right? In 5 or 6 months, the mongoose had grown into full size. A lovely animal with two shining black eyes. See the eyes, black eyes and a bushy tail. The farmer's son was still a baby in the cradle, sleeping, crying, laughing, eating food. So, the same happens for the baby, but the mongoose is growing very fast. Then one day the farmer's wife wanted to go to the market. She fed the baby and rocked him to sleep in his little cradle. Picking up the basket, she said to her husband, I am off to the bazaar. I am off to the bazaar. The baby is sleeping. Keep an eye on him. Frankly, I am not at all believing you and I don't like to leave the child with the mongoose. So, please be here. Stay back here itself. Don't go anywhere. All these instructions were given by the farmer's wife to the farmer. But what happens? Farmer, you may not be afraid. I will be here always. I will see the child. And he too accepted it in a good manner. The mongoose is a friendly animal. It is as sweet as our baby and they were the best friends, you know that. So don't worry, they will be safe. All these were the dialogues of the farmer. But what happens? The wife went away and the farmer had nothing to do in his home. He decided to go out, take a look at his fields. You know the farming fields. Can you able to see the farmer and the farming fields? So he wanted to go there. It was nearby only. It's not far away. He ran into some friends on the way back and didn't return for quite some time. So while moving to the field, he saw his friends. They were chatting for a long time and he went to field. There he visited everything. So it took time, right? The farmer's wife returned home after buying vegetables or groceries from the market. She carried a heavy basket. She found the monkey at the entrance of the house with blood on his face and paws. She jumped to the conclusion that it was her son's blood and the mongoose was a guilty one. The mongoose only killed the baby, and the baby, something happened to my son. She cannot tolerate. Let us see here, dear. The farmer's wife finished her shopping and came back home with a beautiful and basket full of groceries, fresh vegetables and the provisional items, everything. She saw the mongoose sitting outside as if waiting for her. On seeing her, he came to welcome her as a customer. The farmer's wife took one look at the mongoose, just one look at the mongoose, and screamed blood. She cried. The face and paws of the mongoose were smeared with blood. "You wicked animal," immediately she started to scold. "You wicked animal, you have killed my baby," she screamed hysterically. She was blind with rage and with all her strength brought down the heavy basket full of groceries on the blood smeared mongoose and ran inside the child's cradle. The baby was fast asleep, very deep sleep. The baby was in deep sleep. While she was going, how the baby slept, the same way in the cradle, the baby was very safe. But on the floor lay a black snake. Can you able to see that black snake? Torn. The black snake was torn and bleeding. In a flash, just one second, she realized what had happened. She ran out looking for the mongoose. Yes? Oh, you saved the child. You killed the snake. What have I done? She cried, touching the mongoose. Ultimately, she killed the mongoose, of course. Right? Who lay dead and still? See, the mongoose was still and dead. Still is very silent, without any movement. Unaware of her sobbing, sadness, sob is sad. The farmer's wife, who had acted hastily and rashly, stared long at the dead mongoose. See, actually, then she heard the baby crying. So, wiping her tears, she went in to feed him. So, what is the moral of the story? We had the story, we saw the story, and I told you about Panchatantra stories also. This story was taken from the Panchatantra, that also I said. What is the moral? What is the lesson you learned? What is the moral value you learned from the story, dear? So tell me, what is the moral of the story? Without analyzing anything, you should not take a decision, right? See how hardly this mongoose tried to kill that black snake. See, here it was really very tedious when you see fighting with the mongoose and the snake fighting. The mongoose will be bitten by the snake for so many times. The poison would have been there in a full body. How it is tolerating all that? Everything has to be taken into consideration. So, without analyzing, don't take any decision. Don't imagine the situation and act to it. Right? Don't imagine the situation. Don't act immediately. So, that is what is a moral value. I feel this is my own opinion. What is your opinion? What you understood from the story? we will discuss in the live session, right? Now it is question time, right? Shall we move into the question time? So I hope you all will be ready with your notebooks, right? We'll discuss the question, we'll discuss the answer. It is not necessary that you have to write the same answer which I am showing you. This is an idea for you. This will give you the concept. This will give you a betterment of your answers. The first question is, why did the farmer bring a baby mongoose into the house? Why, dear? Very good. Yes, I am hearing your answer louder, please. Very good. The farmer had a small son. He wanted to have a pet to give company to his child. So he brought home a baby mongoose to play with the child. This is what is the first question answer. Suppose if you have any other answer related to this, you can also write that. The second question, why didn't the farmer's wife want to leave the baby alone with the mongoose? Why? The farmer's wife did not trust even her pet mongoose. Nobody will trust when it comes into consideration about the child, their own child. Nobody will trust. Okay? The farmers also did not trust even her pet mongoose. She didn't want to leave her son alone with an animal. She believed her husband only, the farmer, right? She didn't believe the mongoose. Okay. Any doubt in these two questions, dear? Can you able to understand the concept of the story? Can you able to understand the story? Yes. If you have doubts, we'll discuss that. And the third question, why was the farmer's comment on his wife's fear? The farmer understood why his wife was afraid of leaving the baby alone with the mongoose. Therefore, he tried to remove her fear. He said that the mongoose was a friendly mongoose, friendly animal, as sweet and gentle as their own baby. So don't be afraid. This animal is very good. It will not be harmful at all. It is as sweet as our own baby. So that was the answer. The farmer understood why his wife was afraid of leaving the baby alone with the mongoose. Therefore, he tried to remove her fear. He said that the mongoose was a friendly animal, as sweet and gentle as their own baby. Why did the farmer's wife strike the mongoose with her basket? The farmer's wife returned home with a heavy basket. She noticed blood on the face and paws of the mongoose. She had no doubt that the mongoose had killed her son. So in anger, she hit the animal with the basket. The poor mongoose died on the spot. Right? So, really it is horrible. The farmer's wife returned home with a heavy basket. You imagine the situation and the story which we read. She noticed blood on the face and paws of the mongoose. See, suppose if you are in that position, what you will do? She had no doubt that the mongoose had killed her son. So, in anger, she hit the animal with a basket. The poor mongoose died on the spot. Did she repent her hasty action? How does she show her repentance? The farmer's wife saw the snake torn into pieces. Her own son was safely asleep. She realized her mistake. She felt very sorry. She touched the mongoose and cried. She saw the painful result of her hasty action. She felt a lot. Really, I too. And when reading, you too. Right? Do you have a pet, dear? A cat or a dog? If not, would you like to have one? So, how do you look after it? Are you for or against keeping birds in a cage as pet? This is what is the question. You write on your own and send me to your children. right? It's time. Yes, it's time to say thank you.